Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I am Abhishek and you are watching Chessteam. In this video we are going to see the game 2 of our series Bobby Fischer 16 memorable games, the game 2 between Larsen Bent and Bobby Fischer. So stay tuned with me till the video ends. So Fischer is playing as white, starts the game with 1e4, black replies with c6, the Sicilian defense. We have knight to f3, d6, d4, c into d4, knight into d4, we have knight to f6, attacking the pawn, knight c3, g6, bishop e3, bishop g7, f3, short castle, we have queen to d2, for threatening to play bishop h6, exchanging of the key defender by the support of the queen. One should always exchange the key defender of the king. Knight c6, bishop c4, takes the knight, takes with the bishop. The point of taking the knight is first the knight is controlling the center square, and then you distract the bishop, which is threatening to come on h6 and exchange the key defender. Bishop e6, bishop b3, we have queen to a5, white castle queen side. It's a bit risky because the queen is on a5, you can even castle short and it's safe, but doesn't matter, you have many pieces to defend the king. Black plays b5, opening the king side. You should always open the king side where the king is weak. So b6, attacking the knight. Knight moves to d5, takes with the bishop, takes back with the bishop, attacking the rook. Rook moves to f8, bishop comes back. Should always block the isolated pawn, which is pushed. Black plays rook to f7. The idea with doubling the rook, maintaining the battery, we have h4, trying to push the pawn. Queen to b5, h5, rook c8, h into g6, h into g6, we have g4, a5, both the side opening the king side, and here Fischer's exchange sacrifice, the knight with the rook. We have e5, attacking the bishop, takes the pawn, and now the threat is to take it, takes the pawn, takes with the rook. We have discovered attack on the rook, so the rook moves, and then Fischer played bishop to g5, attacking the rook. Now you can't move the rook because I can push the pawn and you can't even block it on the rook to d8 because the bishop is controlling that square. So it is simply queening or you lose the rook. So Fischer can't move the rook, takes the rook, takes with the bishop, push the pawn. Now you can block the rook because the bishop is no longer there, and then the move comes queen to d6, and at this position Larsen Bent resigned the game because let's assume you moved your king. Check. King to h7, takes the bishop, threatening a mate. So queen takes the queen, and then you can simply takes the rook, and that's just winning because you have a queen. I have a queen, bishop and a rook, and I can even threatening a mate in two.
So if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and also do subscribe to the channel for more such